Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you how you can copy and paste your equation from ChatGPT to your doc and retain the format. And then when I talk about equation, I'm talking about those subscripts, those formulas and those, you know, fractions that makes it difficult that you can just copy and paste it. I'm not sure if you have tried it before, but if you have tried it before, when you copy and paste the documents just like this, you eventually get this, which is not the best result. So in this video, I am going to be showing you how you can just, you know, copy and paste and just move on with your work. It's not just going to enhance your workflow, it is also going to, you know, improve your proficiency level. And also I will be showing you how you can copy and paste this thing from your ChatGPT to your WordPress. Yes, apart from working on the Word documents, Microsoft Word and all, it's also imperative some of us just want to do it on a website and all. So I'm going to show you how you can do that also, and how you can write your equations on your website, making it very, very easy. So without further ado, I am Mikey. Let's jump right there. So the first thing you may want to do is, you know, come to your ChatGPT and then put a prompt. Okay, I'm going to tell you to give me an advanced equation. All right, I think I'm loving this already. Okay, I'm just going to give it more soft, some quadratic equation. I mean, just to make it, you know, very clear. So, right, so here we go. This is some quadratic equation. And if you copy this and then move it to your, you know, your Word or your WordPress or whatever, it's just gonna be different if you have tried this before. So here I am in my, you know, like you see, many of it are different. If you zoom in, you can see this is not giving exactly what we want. And if you look at this, this is entirely different from what it was. So how do you do this and make it exactly perfect, just like it was? Well, the first thing you wanna do is, you know, highlight the portion. You can highlight everything. Highlight the portion where the equation is going to be. Click on insert, as I've done. Go to equation and go to insert equation. Second thing you want to do is to right click and make it professional, and that makes it perfect. So you want to do this for all of it, for all. So I'm just going to repeat the same process. Insert equation. And then you make it professional. That's beautiful, isn't it? And then that is just how you have to do every single part of it to make it perfect. So I'm going to pause this video and I'm going to run through the rest. Sometimes you may have to, you know, just make some minor edits. For example, you notice this was b2 here and now it is b2 and not b raised to power 2. So you may have to, you know, extract some of the parts. For example, I noticed in particular that when you copy a chart from ChatGPT and put it on the, you know, Word, it's end up messing up, especially when you want to follow this exact process. So you have to be able to, you know, strike out some part, which is usually the tail. Which is really the head and the tail. This is the head. So the head is just before this B2. You must be able to remove it. For example, I'm removing the part of the head. And then the other part is, you know, where this head ended, just like you can see in my ChatGPT response here, which is just like this. Simple and clear. So this makes it very easy for you to work with this. So what I'm saying, or what I just say, if you don't get that, was I'm going to repeat it, is that when you, you know, when you try to follow the exact process I gave initially, and then you get to realize that, well, there's a difference. There's a difference because you try to insert the equation. Let's see what I'm saying. And then when you start the equation, and then you notice that, okay, you can see this is still different from this. This is different from this. So now what you have to do is, don't panic, just, you know, right click, make it professional. That's the first thing you want to do. And then one that I noticed is usually the head, and there's usually a head and a tail to this. The central content is the real content you need. So it usually repeats itself. It's redundant part of the of the content is the head. So you need to figure out that, you need to find where the real content starts. So for example, I am trying to, okay, notice that, well, I have, these are all redundant parts. These are all redundant parts, and until this particular hex here. So this is where the actual content starts. So I'm going to have to remove this, and then I'm just going to have to, okay, figure out where this stops, and then I have to remove the other part of it. This is peculiar to ChatGPT responses. So this may not be this case if you are using other copy and paste functions. But for ChatGPT, you can see here I have the actual content here. So I'm just going to continue with the video and pause the content. Good, and here we go. Like you see, we have our actual content here. You can just, you know, these are basics. You can just proper format this one yourself. The repeated is. So this will cost a couple of minutes if you are working on a big, document. But like you see, it's relatively perfect. This is a professional content. And this makes it better. This is way better than having to, you know, try to import the content and start from a thing and all of that from here. So that is one. Now, so the second part of the video, what about when you want to copy and paste this exact response to your WordPress? So yes, here I go. So what do I do if I try copying this in specific and put it in here? You're going to see that, man, this is not going to work. This is not working. I mean, apparently you see it's not going to work. You can see it's different. It's just giving this. So what do you do instead of starting from scratch if you have to publish this on your site? First of all, you need to know you have to install a particular plugin. So you have to head on to installing the plugin text. There you go. So I'm going to link the plugin in the description. So just download this plugin first. Primarily, when you have this plugin, then import it in your WordPress admin. So after you have done this, then you need to provide this content in some specific ways for this plugin to be able to read it. So you may want to check some boxes in this plugin settings. So you may want to add on to plugins and then fix some proper settings before you start copying and pasting. So here we go. Maths. So activate the plugin. After activating the plugin, then go to settings and ensure that this is checked. Then save. Then you go to your post, add new post, and then go back to ChatGPT, and then you have to give ChatGPT a particular response. I will also link the response in the description. So you're going to give it ChatGPT this particular. I'm just going to copy and paste it here. So you just have to click on the link to the drive file and then give the code this response from ChatGPT. So when you give it this particular prompt, it is going to return you a particular code, a particular markdown code. That markdown code is what you're going to embed on your website as a short code. So when you embed it on your WordPress as a short code, it's just going to give you exactly what you want without having to, you know. So this is relatively easier than even the part one. So just copy the code, put it here and export it. I'm just going to do that right away. So here we go. And like I see, it's basically giving us a Markdown code, which is a full content of that in code format. So what we are going to do is copy this code, go and embed it as a short code on WordPress, and we're going to get exactly that without having to, you know, start formatting and using superscripts. I mean, the default WordPress feature, which is relatively, you know, much more time consuming and all of that. So I'm just going to move to my other page right now. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to, you know, make sure I'm using a short code. So I'd have to just paste the short code and give this a title if I want. Save drafts, and then I'm going to preview drafts so you guys can see exactly what it looks like. Good. All right, initially I was super confused, but yeah, here we go. So look at this. I mean, that was easy. And by the way, you could head up to KPC and subscribe for this kind of nugget. So yes, and last but not the least, this is a bonus information. If you don't want to do this, you can just, you know, do the work primarily in your WordPress. You don't want to use a short code, but honestly, I don't know why you would not want to use a short code. You can easily start, you know, typing out your stuff and A X square. You have to, you know, put the A and then come down here, use a superscript and all of that. But that's extremely time consuming if you're. That brings us to the end of this tutorial. I have learned something. I want you to give a thumbs up, subscribe, and turn off the notification bell and just wait for more. Hi, I'm Mikey, by the way, and I'll catch you in the next one.